Hey guys, Justin here of Figatech. So we've been using this Huawei MatePad 11 for a couple of weeks now, and we can say that it's one of Huawei's bang for your buck tablets. With Harmony OS making it easier to deal with the lack of Google Mobile services, the question is, how does it compare to other Android tablets out there? Now you've read the title, we have here the Samsung Galaxy Tab S7 Fan Edition and the Huawei MatePad 11. These two tablets are expected to have flagship-grade performance with not-so-high-end price tags. And on that note, let's see how they fare against each other. Starting with design. Certainly, the first thing you'll notice between the two is their sizes. The Huawei MatePad 11 has a 10.95-inch IPS display, while the Galaxy Tab S7 FE has a 12.4-inch TFT screen. There's a pretty reasonable heft on both, but of course, the Samsung with its larger screen real estate has a heavier weight of 608 grams. Huawei, on the other hand, is both lighter and easier to bring anywhere at 485 grams. As for their design aesthetics, the Huawei MatePad 11 looks simple and elegant in an aluminum body in this matte gray color. On the other hand, the Galaxy Tab S7 FE that we have is in the mystic green color with a metallic build and boxy-like edges. Both at their backs are their protruding camera modules with a microphone, plus there's also some Huawei and Samsung branding. Since their front cameras and LED indicators can be found on the longer side of their bezels, we'll use them more in landscape mode. As for buttons and ports, starting with Huawei, we get two loudspeakers and a power button on the left, two more loudspeakers on the right together with a USB Type-C port, the volume rocker and three microphones up top, and a card tray at the bottom that's dedicated for a micro SD card for up to 1 TB. The Huawei MatePad 11 is a Wi-Fi-only tablet. In the other corner, we get the single loudspeaker, microphone, and some antenna bands on the left side of the Galaxy Tab S7 FE. Then on the right side are its USB-C port, together with one more loudspeaker. It has all the buttons on top, that's the power or lock button and the volume rocker. And then we also get here a single microphone with a card tray for one nano SIM plus a micro SD card for up to 1 TB as well. At the bottom, it has a magnetic connector for the keyboard accessory, generally both of which give a premium and professional impression. But as we all know, we all have our own personal preferences when it comes to design, so we'll let you decide on that. On a side note though, we do appreciate the lightweight of the Huawei MatePad 11, which makes it easier to bring wherever you want to work or study. Now let's talk about their compatible accessories. You can use these two tablets with their respective pencil and magnetic keyboard tools. Samsung have them included in the package, while Huawei gives you the option to buy them separately in case you won't really need them. Although currently, the M Pencil 2 and the Huawei MatePad 11 cover are bundled as freebies. So we have the longer M Pencil 2 for Huawei that seamlessly connects via Bluetooth, and the standard S Pen for Samsung which doesn't rely on Bluetooth connectivity. Both are ergonomically comfortable to grip and they magnetically attach to the side of the tablets. However, the Huawei M Pencil 2 is more advanced and is honestly smoother to use on the display with its platinum-coated nib. It's got an input latency as low as 2 milliseconds and it has a better sensitivity as well. There's a double tap feature on it too, so you can switch between drawing tools with ease for supported apps. Meanwhile, Samsung's S Pen here is a bit awkward to use on the display. Don't get me wrong, it's highly responsive as well, but it's not something you would prefer if you'll be doing a lot of sketches. There's no quirky air gestures here since that's reserved for the higher Samsung tablets, so naturally, it's good for basic tasks and for navigating the UI. When it comes to their compatible keyboards, Huawei Smart Magnetic Keyboard attaches with a strong magnet and syncs through Bluetooth. Meanwhile, Samsung's book cover keyboard also attaches magnetically but syncs with a magnetic connector at the bottom of the device. Samsung gives a more laptop feel due to its large size, so it's good if you'll do a lot of typing. Huawei's keyboard is also very nice, especially for on-the-go use, and hey, it's always better than typing on the screen. So enough about the accessories, let's talk more about their displays. Up front, the Huawei MatePad 11 shows a 120Hz 10.95-inch IPS LCD display with a pixel density of 275 pixels per inch. The Samsung Galaxy Tab S7 FE, on the other hand, packs an obviously larger 60Hz 12.4-inch TFT LCD panel with a pixel density of 243 pixels per inch, both of which have a Quad HD resolution and they're able to play up to 4K videos on YouTube. When it comes to screen size, the Samsung Galaxy Tab S7 FE is slightly larger, but quality-wise, Huawei looks more vibrant and it has a 120Hz refresh rate plus a low 2 milliseconds latency that makes the use of the M Pencil 2 more responsive and smooth. That's why we're giving the points for display to the Huawei MatePad 11. When it comes to audio quality, the Huawei MatePad 11 has a quad speaker setup that are all tuned by Harman Kardon. Meanwhile, the Galaxy Tab S7 FE only has two loudspeakers that are backed by AKG and Dolby Atmos. Samsung's audio quality is pretty decent, it's comparable to most mid-range smartphones today. But as for Huawei, its quad speaker setup is booming with excellent sound quality that has clear highs, mids, and even bass. It can pretty much be a portable speaker replacement. Having four speakers is generous enough for its price range, but having it backed by Harman Kardon gives us that crisp flagship-grade quality. Alright, let's finally tackle what most of you want to know about these two tablets, their software. The Huawei MatePad 11 is equipped with the brand's very own Harmony OS 2.0. Meanwhile, the Samsung Galaxy Tab S7 FE runs One UI 3.1 that's based on Android 11. Appearance-wise, these two interfaces look well-organized and dynamic. Although it's hard to miss that Huawei's new OS has some resemblance to Apple's iOS, with still retaining some EMUI features. It's mostly a good thing since it's a clean and familiar look that most people prefer. And as for Samsung's One UI, it features a customizable and fun look. These two tablets give you an option to use an app drawer and navigation gestures, but when it comes to desktop mode, things are a little different. The Galaxy Tab S7 FE is equipped with Samsung's DeX platform that provides that PC-like experience, so you can maximize multitasking and accessibility. The Huawei MatePad 11, on the other hand, also has a desktop mode. Its standard interface already gives a PC-like vibe, plus it has some useful multitasking quirks on its own. We get a nice app dock below, and swiping from the left or right edges of the screen will show apps that you can easily drag for a multi-window or split-screen view. You can even minimize multiple apps on a multi-window view so that you can access them like a messenger chat head. Huawei tablets with the Harmony OS 2.0, despite not having Google Mobile services, makes it easier now to download non-Google third-party apps with the App Gallery and Petal Search widget. So such apps like Microsoft Word, Netflix, Zoom, Instagram, Canva, Filmorago, and others aren't a problem to download at all. Google services, however, can still be accessed via a web browser. This tablet also comes with Huawei Share, so you can seamlessly connect your Huawei smartphone or laptop. Plus, there's the multi-screen collaboration feature that allows it to become a dedicated sketchpad to the MateBook using mirror mode. You can also use the extend mode so it becomes a secondary monitor. Then there's collaborate mode that you can use to easily make cross-OS transfers. Samsung's One UI 3.1, on the other hand, also has notable features including continue apps on other devices if you own other Samsung Galaxy devices. There's also quick share and robust S Pen features that the company is known for. And of course, there's Google Mobile services. While we were able to access Google Mobile services and sideload APKs on the Huawei MatePad 11, it requires some technical know-how. If you're the type who's into tinkering Android devices, then the lack of Google services shouldn't hamper you that much. Plus, you're getting exclusive Huawei Mobile Services features, which is like having the best of both worlds. But for those who are into convenience and can't be bothered to sideload apps, then the Galaxy Tab S7 FE is a more comfortable solution. Moving on to performance, under the hood, the Huawei MatePad 11 has a Qualcomm Snapdragon 865 chipset, while the Samsung Galaxy Tab S7 FE packs a Snapdragon 750G processor. They both have 6GB of RAM and 128GB of internal storage that's expandable for up to 1TB via their microSD card slots. Generally, both deliver very good performance for day-to-day use. However, the Snapdragon 865 on the Huawei MatePad 11 significantly performs better and smoother. I mean, this is clearly apparent from the benchmark scores that we got from both. The two can handle basic activities smoothly as well as heavy games, but expect a lot of frame drops from the Samsung Tab S7 FE if you're using the highest settings available. Battery-wise, the Huawei MatePad 11 comes equipped with a 7,250 mAh capacity with 22.5W fast charging. On the other hand, the larger Galaxy Tab S7 FE comes with a 10,090 mAh capacity with 45W fast charging. In our day-to-day experience, the Huawei MatePad 11 can last you a full day on moderate use, which is acceptable enough since we get a smooth 120Hz IPS display and a Snapdragon 865 chipset. Meanwhile, the Galaxy Tab S7 FE can last you up to 2 days with minimal use since it does have a larger battery capacity. Now let's go about their cameras. You most likely won't use these for mobile photography because of their large sizes, so brands don't really put much effort into it, except for Huawei in this case. We've seen the cameras on the MatePad Pro 12.6 and they deliver very good quality for a pro tablet. Now this Huawei MatePad 11 packs the same main 13MP rear camera and 8MP front camera that gives off clear shots with more details compared to the Galaxy Tab S7 FE. The 8-megapixel rear camera on the Galaxy Tab S7 FE isn't that bad at all. It can be muddy sometimes but surely can still be vibrant under good lighting scenarios. However, I can't say the same for its 5-megapixel front camera because it often produces grainy shots, which isn't highly recommendable if you'll be doing a lot of video calls. Speaking of which, here are samples of their front cameras for video calling. As for videos with their rear cameras, you can shoot up to 4K at 30 frames per second for the Huawei MatePad 11, while the Samsung Galaxy Tab S7 FE lets you shoot up to 1080p at 30 frames per second with a stabilization toggle that you can turn on in the settings. To conclude this comparison, let's first talk about their prices. The Huawei MatePad 11 has an SRP of 26,999 pesos, while the Samsung Galaxy Tab S7 FE is available for 39,990 pesos. If we're talking about a bang for your buck tablet, then we can say that the Huawei MatePad 11 takes the praise for its highly competitive price, beastly performance, 120Hz display, and not to mention its seamless M-Pen2 experience. I can definitely see professionals and creatives using this tablet a lot. Yes, it might not have Google Mobile services, but as discussed earlier, there's a workaround to having access to Google services. That is not to say that you shouldn't consider the Samsung Galaxy Tab S7 FE. This one also has good performance and features that creatives are looking for. It has a more convenient way of accessing Google services, has LTE connectivity, and also has its own set of features that you will find very useful, especially if you're already in the Galaxy ecosystem. However, do note that that would cost you an extra 13,000 pesos. So which one should you get? If you're on a budget and know your way around Android and are already in the Huawei ecosystem, and you're okay with Google Mobile Services workarounds, then we think that the Huawei MatePad 11 can provide much more value for your money. But if you have the extra budget, then the Galaxy Tab S7 FE won't hurt having. And yeah, that wraps up this tablet comparison review. How about you guys? Which do you prefer more? The Huawei MatePad 11 or the Samsung Galaxy Tab S7 Fan Edition? Do let us know in the comments. And of course, if you found this video helpful, be sure to drop a like, subscribe to our channel for more content, hit that bell icon so you don't miss any future uploads, and be sure to visit yugatech.com for the latest tech news and reviews. Once again, this is Justin, and don't forget to wash your hands and stay at home.